lost nearly half a season to a groin injury, 35 games in all. And we're underway. Our opening faceoff brought to you by Irvine Auto Center. Ducks in their home blacks. Back to the play. Here's Elias Pettersson sitting on 99 points into the Anaheim zone. And he moves it in front, and Dostal denies DiGiuseppe. Pettersson has been a problem for the Ducks in three games this season. He's produced 9 points, and he'll take this shot that goes off of Dostal and out of play.
It's going to require that all of his youngsters continue to build strength over the course of the offseason.
Canucks into the Anaheim zone. Brock Besser pulls it in and lets it go off of Dostal. It stays in off the high glass. He'll head to the bench and change as Anaheim flips it out and does the same.
John, you and I were talking. If you look at the NHL list.
Here's Pettersson and a glove save by Dostal. And he doesn't appear to come off the ice very much either.
Almost 26 minutes a game. He's the engine back there that really drives a lot of their offense.
And he sends it in and goes right down the center lane, and the shot off the wing got a piece of the goalpost.
Vancouver opportunity. You see the shot come in from DiGiuseppe. And I think Dostal never saw it. There was a player kind of crossing right in front of his vision. Actually deflects off the stick of Jackson Lacombe.
As the Canucks keep the pressure on. Ethan Bear shot from the left point, blocked by Lundestrom. He'll go right up the middle. Partial break. In on Demko. Backhand. Stretching the left leg. The San Diego native makes the save.
By Lucas Dostal. And then the breakaway bid by Isaac Lundestrom. Hard to go around a 6'4" goaltender. A long left leg. It's been pretty good for them all season long. Ranked 12th going into this game tonight.
Yeah, Hughes' shot misses the net. However, in their last 5 games, just 1 of 17. Hughes walks the line. Drops it off for JT Miller. Miller snaps it all the way through, and Besser scores on a feed from Pettersson. There it is, point number 100 for Elias Pettersson. He becomes the 11th player in the National Hockey League this season to reach the century mark.
One-touch passes go through the middle of the penalty-killing box. You don't have any chance at all. Boy, what a play by Elias Pettersson. He just zips that right into the wheelhouse of Brock Besser, who quietly has turned his season around. That's now goal number 18.
And it's lobbed to the neutral zone. Sheldon Dries tripped up by Zegras. Another penalty coming up to the Ducks. Kuzmenko behind the net. They move it around into the slot. And what a save by Dostal on a hard shot from between the circles by Sheldon Dries. Talked with Bo this morning. He said he worked a lot this season on his offensive game. Been on the top line down in San Diego most of the year, playing in all special team situations, he told me. Really worked a lot on puck possession and puck protection. Here's Kuzmenko behind the defense. He takes the feed and scores. Andre Kuzmenko, whose 39 goals are a Vancouver record.
Kuzmenko's just wide open. I mean, he's right in between two veteran Anaheim defenders. And that's an easy breakaway. Great pass. Zipped right up and onto the tape. It was Rose who put that right into the wheelhouse of Kuzmenko.
Now at 22 goals on the season is Henrique. The trailer through center is Zegras. And the Ducks back into the Vancouver zone on the power play. Strome off the boards to McTavish. Out high, Fowler. Zegras gives it back to Cam. One-timer. McTavish scores.
This game with a blast. But see how high the forwards are, and as a result, Mason McTavish. It's funny, you know, Elias Pettersson loses Mason McTavish. He gets focused on the puck.
I focused in on his first shift. He made a very nice outlet pass from deep in the corner, rink wide out to the neutral zone, and went right to the bench. And he said, yep, he said it was just get to the bench, it's over, I did it. And he said everybody on the bench told me I made a nice pass. Fourth game for him since signing out of Ohio State. Cole McWard played 2 years with the Buckeyes. Ducks get it right to the top of the goal crease. Jones is stopped, and coming from behind the net, a chance for Nestorenko.
Just absolutely robbed him. Good play by Lundestrom. Look at that left pad stop by Thatcher Demko.
You see him working alongside John Shorthouse. The two of them have been partners for 15 years. Cheech and Shorty, if you will. He did tell me that he's... Oh, here's one off the post and in. Drew Helison has his first National Hockey League goal.
Hit the inside of the post. Zegras does a good job penetrating in the zone. Little drop pass from Terry. That was a knuckleball. Did you see that puck drop? Watch this thing. Rolling puck. Yeah. That drops about a foot and a half. You got a lot on it.
As it comes to the high slot, Nestorenko hands it back to Jones, who turns on the Jets. Nestorenko gets to it right at the top of the crease. A save made by Demko and a penalty coming up.
Just to see how this puck did not go in. Good job by Jones. Crashed the net. That puck is sitting in the front of the goal crease there. And Demko wisely sprawls right along the goal line.
And it's going to be Tyler Myers for a hold here. The Canucks and Ducks all square at two. Anaheim has lost each of the first three meetings this season, including an overtime loss at Vancouver back on the 8th of March. JT Miller wins the puck battle with Henrique and sends it up the right side. Pettersson looking for a trailer. He finds it. It's Hughes into the slot. All alone, DiGiuseppe. And that's kicked away by Dostal.
He came late and nobody picked him up entering the zone.
McWard strides it over. And Pettersson behind the back. Miller gives it right back to him. Elias Pettersson picked up his 100th point in the opening period. Now stick handles high in the zone. Sends it across. Rebound score! JT Miller has given Vancouver the lead again.
One less defenseman guarding the front of the net. There's Lacombe. And he's going to stay with Pettersson. Take him all the way out to the blue line. That's what he's supposed to do. But and the forward down low has got a cover for him and get back to the top of the goal crease, and you can see nobody picks up JT Miller. And that's a tap-in goal for him. It does.
The veteran hands it off and gets it right back. Now it's Terry. Shattenkirk's shot got the glass and the rebound off the board, swatted over top of the net by Grant. Leaderboard, he's got an assist tonight. Gibson, of course, not in action, but the Ducks power play, Casey coming very close.
Well, it was all Thatcher Demko. That was an amazing stop. He knew he had to get that puck up to get it over the leg pad of Demko, but just kind of airmailed that one.
Troy Terry shot off of Demko. Loose rebound. Couple of tremendous saves by Demko on Silverberg.
The reaction of Derek, and then later on, two beauties against Jakob Silverberg. That left leg pad of Thatcher Demko came up absolutely huge. The question for the coach, do I make it 6-on-4? Get an extra guy in front of the net.
Face off won by Anaheim. Zegras gets it down low. Demko with a 10 bell save.
Pucks with all kinds of traffic in front. Gets down low. Boy, that puck almost goes off the goal stick and up and over the leg pad of the goaltender. Another look from a different angle. See how that puck kind of elevates.
Pettersson settles it, and it flops in the air to center, stays in the barn, and the horn sounds. The Canucks hang on down the stretch.